Have you heard about the robot vacuum cleaner? I evolved him twice. Basically, 2 years ago, when I was busy with installing and I had little time to clean, I had an idea. Why not invent a cleaning system?
Take it.
So I began developing what I call Roombot. The journey was really tough, costly, and my initial attempt failed. But refusing to give up, I transferred this idea into my final year university project, the Roombot 2. With greater effort and university funding, I managed to continue this invention. This project earned me a Euler Award for the best final year project at the University of Sheffield, but I still am considering it only a partial success. So this video is a story of Roombot 1 and Roombot 2, born from 2 years of dedication and challenges. Join me as I share how it succeeded and where did it fail. Let's start from the beginning. University life is challenging, relentless, and really hard. Picture students overwhelmed by their workload. It's a place of extreme stress, transforming other living spaces into chaotic jungles. There is an unspoken rule: the more knowledge you gain, the more mess you create. So basically, the more you learn, the more messy your room becomes. The day I started carving paths through my room like a maze, I knew things need to change. So I started cleaning, but it felt like a never-ending cycle. Clean one day, back to square one on the next day. No matter how many times I tried, the results were always the same. The room just kept getting dirtier and dirtier as it was allergic to being clean. I was about to wave the white flag, or at least use it to cover the mess. But I went to sleep, hoping that this is just a nightmare and that I will wake up to a clean room. Then one fateful night, amidst my frustration, came a vision. The dream that would change everything. A dream of a room with its own mind tiny after me. In my dream, I would come back from university to a sparkling clean room. It was like walking into a fairy tale, minus the talking animals. But then a bus shattered my dream and I woke up to a reality. My room. In all the chaotic glory. It looked like a before photo in a cleaning room ad. I was devastated that it was just a dream. Realizing that it was just a dream hit me harder than a pile of unwashed laundry. But then the idea came to my mind. No, it's not that one that helps find the lost socks. I need to bring my dream to life. Create a room that cleans itself. How hard could it be, right? You know the saying, easier said than done? This is an example of it. This would require rebuilding my entire room, which was beyond my budget. But hey! I'm an engineer with 7 years of experience of DIY and duct tape. How hard could it be to outsmart a mess? So that's how my grand plan began. Build a robot. Not just any robot, but a robot with a passion for cleaning. A kind of robot butler, minus the tuxedo. A robot cleaning room. A Roombot. And so the idea to create Roombot was born. My very own cleaning crusader in the world of cluster. With the idea in mind, it's time to roll up my sleeves and dive in. We can't just clone a Roomba, can we? Plus, I'm not in the mood for a copyright lawsuit. Besides, Roomba has a hobby of getting stuck, like a cat in a tree. The real villain here is the clutter and Everest stuff on the floor. So the robot needs to be able to move stuff left and right. So it could be a robot with a robotic hand, or as I like to call it, the handy bot.
It will pick up things and put them somewhere elsewhere.
Like a helpful poltergeist. Reinventing the wheel isn't my style, so let's use some off-the-shelf kits. But how to control this mechanical marvel? With the budget I have, making it fully autonomous is like expecting a goldfish to do taxes. I want to try a more natural control, like a puppet master, but for cleaning. What about the hand controller? Like a high-tech glove, and it could let me control the robot and its hand. It's like being a wizard, but for chores. Oh, that's the basic plan. The devil is in details, which I will figure out eventually. Yeah, it worked out just fine.
Famous last words.
Now that we have a general idea, it's shopping time. So those few inexpensive kits should be perfect for my cleaning revolution. A mobile base to roam around, and a robotic hand, because what kind of robot would it be without one? Combining those two, we should reach what we want, right? So all parts finally arrived. Time to get to work. First up, the mobile base, the foundation of the robot. Now it's time to assemble the manipulator. But some parts looked like they have seen better days. Some of the parts were already broken. It was a good thing I got a trusty 3D printer. It's like a magic hat for inventors. Putting the robotic hand together was quite a handful. But let's test it out. This is the test of the robotic claw. That looks promising, doesn't it? Next, the hand controller. It's not gonna win any beauty awards, but well, it's a prototype. That's how about they look like. No, all things go as planned. A little super glue here and there. Some programming magic. Wait, who said stealing? I mean, borrowing the code isn't bad, right? Besides, I'm gonna make sure to return it back when I found it later. I'll spare you the other technical details. And voila, we have a semi-functional cleaning robot.
It's
like a Frankenstein of the robot world. Is it just me or are we missing two tires? Maybe they're on a vacation. I'm sure we can do without them, right? I will count them as spare parts that we just spared from being used. Okay, it's not a tech marvel yet, but it's super cool. Let's give it a try. The controls are quite quirky. By controlling it with my hand, it's still a win in my book. Movement of my hand changes the position of the robotic hand. The fingers control the claw, and the elbow controls the robotic elbow. This is the test of the robot on the battery. It uses radio signals for communication and control. Now I'm going to make him face those pesky sponges. Grab it, my creation. Grab it!
Look at that, it's able to pick up some sponges.
Now let's pile them up. Nice! First one done.
If your kitchen ever gets invaded by sponges, who you gonna call? Roomba.
That works! It's on the job! Now let's take those sponges back where they belong. It's actually pretty fast, faster than expected. That makes it a bit difficult to control.
Now all the sponges should be where. Time to level up our invention like a monster in a video game. I hope it evolves into a cool robot too. Well, truth to be told, I took actually a 2 years break on project. Even inventors need to take breaks, you know, and they need to recharge. But opportunity knocked again when I needed a 1 year long project for university. And so I always was really fascinated by robots. I really wanted to make it work, make a special robot that can change the world for better. And this is how I got to give it a second chance and develop this marvel.
Project name: Bridging the Gaps in Robotics.
The goal: a domestic robot that doesn't break the bank.
I mean, for the sweet spot, so more high-tech than Roomba, but less Terminator-like humanoid robots. So forget the sponges, this time we're tackling the socks invasion. First up, the all-important research phase. Spoiler alert, my robot will be the coolest. Fast forwarding the boring bits, now it's time for the fun part, picking components. Ever dream of a robot with laser eyes and legs? Well, maybe next project. We're not making this type of robot now, but maybe later. Could imagine it to be something like this. But we need something cooler than wheels for its base. Something that can pass through objects without issue, like a tank. Wait, that's it, let's just make a tank. And it needs to scoop as well, cause no items left behind. We'll throw in some lithium for the extra battery, and a camera for eyes, robotic hand for grip, and some boron vacuum cleaner bumpers, packed with sensors, computers, fancy LED lights, and more, cause why not? Alright, and let's make it talk too. I can imagine it being like Butler. Okay, quickly designing a prototype of the model. First I will start with designing the bumper, similar to the one that we're gonna steal from another robot. It does look very cool, doesn't it? But let's crank up the cool factor. Second prototype needs to be even sleeker. Aha, this design got the edge. That's ready, it looks awesome! Next, I designed the electronics governing the entire system. This is the main circuit responsible for sensing, transmitting information and actuating. And that's how we completed it. Another tick on my list. At last, it's time to turn the spans into reality. But of course, we need to get the parts too. First, let's jump some funds out of the university. All set? Order everything!
Now that we know which parts we get, I can start designing the final prototype. This is the base of the robot. It will work as the foundation to the entire system. Now I will work on the scoop for holding objects. It needs to be very sturdy. Light. I also needed to create a custom tracked caterpillar belt for my robot. Now I'm going to develop the suspension for the robot. The red part represents the spring. Now we can put those together and move to developing the belt tensioner. I really got to complete this model,
as the university will murder me if I keep showing them small models. Okay, in the spirit of work smarter, not harder, I bought and modified a brassy robotic arm. Why reinvent the wheel, right?
You can see this robotic hand on top of the base, as I integrated it into the design, just putting the other side together. That's almost everything. That's complete! I'm happy how it turned out. Okay, we have the design ready, but first let's test out the robotic hand.
Robotic hand versus the sponge. Let's see who is better. Assembled and tested, and it's looking good and feeling good. I also created a simulation for the arm movement. It's like teaching it to dance with math. And I turned my smart handphone one into a remote controller. It's like turning your phone in a magic wand. Now the grand finale, printing and assembling our robotic masterpiece. With the parts ready, it's time to start the robotic puzzle.
First, we're printing all those puzzles out. Once I printed the base, I tested it with NEMA motors and the Arduino, if it fits and if there is no problems there. Then I also tested with the manipulator microcontroller and the Raspberry Pi. At this point, I had the scoop and part of the bumper printed, so I get to assembling those. Here is my first test on the suspension system. I integrated the spring suspension so that the robot can better manage rough surfaces of the clustered room. Then I printed the custom caterpillar bed for my tank. I mean robot? Oh, and this is the cool view of locomotion system with the suspension in place. On this picture we can see that I needed to raise the base to give some more space for electronics. Then I dumped some very awful job on the wiring. And this project messed up my room entirely. But I'm going to leave it like this, otherwise candles my robot will clean it after me. So the mess kept piling up. After a few rounds of fiddling and fixing, its main subsystem started to work. Now the moment of truth, putting it all together.
One eternity later.
It's a big reveal, let's switch it on. Hey, it's alive, it's alive!
Roombot, can you introduce yourself?
Roombot humbly introduces itself. Roombot is a mobile robot assistant designed and built by Peter. Roombot is equipped with a durable caterpillar chassis, allowing it to traverse a variety of terrains. Its manipulator arm, equipped with precision sensors, can perform an array of tasks, from simple to complex ones. Roombot is fitted with a camera for visual data collection and distance sensors for obstacle avoidance, ensuring safe navigation. It also features Wi-Fi connectivity, enabling remote operation and data transmission. Roombot's scoop mechanism allows it to transport objects securely, assisting in various tasks. It runs on reliable lithium-ion batteries, which ensure extended operation without frequent need for recharging. Roombot is here to serve and assist Peter.
Now, my robot, take this saw! Wait, stop, it's embarrassing. Take it! What? What's wrong? No way! But why? Turns out, my stepper water drives decided to take unplanned vacation. I managed to do some tests and corrections before the budget set.
Nope!
Unfortunately, the footage of this test is gone. Now that my motor drives are fried, I can't repeat this test. But I managed to use the pictures from my report to sort of show how the test went. Still, the fact that my robot is broken is frustrating. You know, seeing the robot struggle, it's hard not to feel a bit down. But then I remember, every great invention has its ups and downs. This isn't the end of the robot, it's just another step in the journey. Every screw tightened, every line of code written was a lesson learned. And that's what inventing is all about, right? It's about pushing through the impossible, about learning and growing. Robot may be down now, but we've come too far to give up. So I would take what I've learned, head out to the whiteboard, and come back stronger. That's a promise. The fact is, 9 out of 10 robots are left and not completed. I refuse to make Roombot another one of those. So support Roombot in his journey. He's got the entire future in front of him. He will thank you all for the support. I'm sure of it. And that's my friends is where we are with the Roombot right now. But the journey is far from over. In fact, I think it's just getting started. I would love to hear your thoughts. What would you add and change in Roombot? Tell me about your ideas in the comments. Let's innovate together. And don't forget to subscribe and hit that like button. Not just to support Roombot, but to stay tuned and witness his grand comeback. Next time he will knock your socks off, literally. So thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video and I will see you in the next video. Until then, keep inventing.